Hello, captains. This is the Doctor. Welcome to Star Trek Online. This is my 100th video. Can you believe it? 100th video of this particular Let's Play series of my free-to-play Star Trek Online character. I've been playing the Federation series here for a very long time. Since 2015, I have been working on this particular playthrough of the Federation, an updated playthrough compared to my very first playthrough I did in like 2012 or something. So this is a much more updated run through of the game, and this is the free-to-play edition of the game, which I had never played before, only the paying version, and I wanted to play it. Well, welcome to my 100th video on this series. I can't believe it. It made it that far. It took that many videos just to get to the end of the missions. And what a coincidence that the 100th video ends up being the last storyline mission video for the game. Quite interesting how that turned out. I really didn't expect that. But there you go, 100 videos. I've never had any other series of Let's Play on my channel that I've done where I've had 100 videos. So this is the first one where it took 100 videos to get through the series, and I'm not even done yet. There's still more to come. But yeah, pretty amazing. So for those wondering, will there be more stuff after this? Stay tuned to the end of this video. I will go over what is to come on Rami Summers, more videos and so forth. And also, just to let you know, I will be starting up a new Let's Play series as well. I'm going to be doing the Agents of Yesterday in the 23rd century Starfleet run through of this game. So stay tuned for that. It'll be a brand new series I'm starting, and so that will be something brand new to keep us interested. But I'm gonna go over everything at the end of this video so that you will know what to expect in the future in terms of this character you see on the screen now, this playthrough I've been doing, because I will be continuing it. It'll just be longer intervals between the videos than it has been in the past. And then the next series I have coming up that I will be working on. So today we're going to play the last storyline mission that's in this game under Future Proof called Ragnarok. We'll talk about the mission and talk about our future and everything at the end. Okay, let's just get straight to this. The final battle against the Sphere Builders will take place at Procyon 5. And some of the greatest minds in the last several centuries will need to come together to save both past and future.
Noi and his allies have engaged Alliance forces at Procyon 5 in the 26th century. Your work at New Kitamar allowed us to summon our ships to the battle, but they may not arrive in time. The combined power of the enemy fleet may be more than we can handle. Join the Alliance fleet as soon as you can. We must face the enemy, and we must win, or all of history will be lost.
We're going to get a specialization qualification temporal operative stuff, Trellium D, which is from Enterprise, some disruptor stuff or phaser stuff or plasma stuff. So we'll go over all of that at the end. Let's transwarp straight there and get the show on the road. Nothing new in terms of gear since the last episode. This is pretty much what I've got right now, is what I've been playing with for the last few episodes. Continuing the reputation, of course, but just have not gotten to the highest tier yet to get all the pieces I want.
Time is short, my friends, so I'll make this quick. The battle is not going well for us. We have already lost Daniels. We're outnumbered and outgunned. Our plan relies on the Tox Uthot. With it, we can destabilize the Expanse and force the Sphere Builders to withdraw. There's only one ship with the power to use the Tox Uthot effectively, the Enterprise. She must survive at all costs. Today we're fighting for the past, present, and future. So fight hard and fight well. Dismissed.
So this is where we're going to meet the Enterprise J at Procyon 5. The Sphere Builders have started to generate an expanse. Radiation levels are rising in the sector. It won't be long before our shields and life support systems are overwhelmed. Reroute power to shields and life support as needed. There's a lot of enemy ships out there. The Enterprise looks like she might be getting overwhelmed. Fortunately for them, the cavalry has
arrived. We're more than just the cavalry. We have the means to put an end to this whole conflict. The Tox Uthot.
All ships, this is Chekov. Protect the Enterprise at all costs. We must get the Tox Utah to the Enterprise.
Here we go. The Battle of the Centuries.
All ships, defend the Enterprise at all costs. Krennan ships on intercept course. Weapons hot.
Target shield
has failed. We got you back!
Going. We must reach the Enterprise. Terran ships ahead. They're trying to intercept us.
The sphere builder ships really do a number
You're
to your hull.
A little late to the party. Too late, in fact. Terran forces, this is the Admiral. Give them no quarter. Onward to victory. For the Empire!
I don't even see the Terran ships. Where are they? Are they these ones up here? I guess so. Yeah, I was going to say, the Sphere Builder ships, they really do something to your hull that really, really devastates it.
Our course is about to breach!
Foragon
Mayday!
Ships inbound.
Mayday! Our course is about to breach!
All ships, defend the Enterprise at all costs! Terran ships are attacking the Enterprise!
Wow, wow, wow. Yeah, those ships are devastating, man. Devastating. They hit really hard. It's a nice challenge. I'd like to see an STF with the Sphere Builders. I don't know, does Procyon 5? I don't think it has. Oh, maybe it does have the Sphere Builders in it. Yeah, the STF.
Leading boarding parties on Enterprise. Multiple decks. All ships, defend the Enterprise at all costs.
Engaging hostiles, command. Weapons hot!
Hull integrity below 50%.
They're almost there. Keep going. We've done it. Find a suitable location, and I will beam down with you.
Okay. Scanning. Got it. Found a transport site close to an engineering center on Enterprise. Enemy presence there is minimal for now. Alright, let's go to Enterprise. Now this is cool. The engineering center isn't far, Admiral, but I'm reading multiple enemy life signs ahead. We'll need to hit them hard and fast before they can beam in reinforcements.
behind us!
You mean in front of us?
Captain Dax to all hands! Brace for impact! Captain Dax to all hands! Brace for impact!
Sounds pretty rough out there.
Yes, let me contact command on this. Wait! My transponder's missing!
Did someone call for a miracle worker then?
Scotty?
That would be this wee temporal beacon. Once activated, it brought me here. Somehow.
Bullshit.
I've been holding onto that beacon for many a year, waiting for a signal. Better late than never, I suppose. Where and when are we, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, we're on board the Enterprise J in the 26th century.
Oh, aye. Judging by the sounds of things, I'd say we're the kind of trouble the Enterprise is getting to regularly. Am I right?
Yep.
Well, we better get to it then. Wouldn't want to let a fine lady like this down, would we?
Nope, we would not. So Scotty comes out of freaking nowhere. Yeah, that's a bit jarring too. Remember how I mentioned jarring stuff in the last video, the last episode? Well, there's some more of that jarring stuff for you. If you haven't played the 23rd century Starfleet run-through, Agents of Yesterday stuff, you will have no idea why he's here. So, craziness. Apparently there's a storyline for him, but not in this...
Not in these
missions we played.
Wait until you see her on the outside.
Are we in some sort of nebula?
That's cool.
Verse. And if we don't stop it, we're all done for. More borders!
Oh, I think I'll manage. Look at this gadget of yours hooked up in no time.
I accidentally went through his stuff too fast. Basically, we gotta integrate the Tox Uthot into the ship.
Alright, we need to reconfigure these consoles to work the Tox Uthot. Incoming! Keep working, Scotty! Keep your head down over there!
Personal shield losing power.
Consoles realigned. Now activate them so we can put them to use.
We'll realign the consoles. Watch out for our friends from the Terran Empire.
They're still using
behind
it.
You! These Terrans don't give up, do they? The same.
As in the
so
mirror
let's get
universe?
This done quickly,
no tears and agonizers? Let's deploy the core integration chamber and wrap this up.
Hopefully, we won't get any more uninvited guests.
Now why'd you say that? We're bound to get some now.
Nice try. But you're done here.
Lita?
Oh, none of you look like the beg for mercy type, so let's just skip to your execution, shall we?
You were right, Scotty. Unfortunately.
Aye, let's deal with this angry lass and her band of thugs.
Lass? Ooh, I like you. Take the Scotsman alive. Kill the rest.
She fights like a Klingon.
The Haggis is in the fire, for sure.
I might be getting too old for this.
Well, I think we're all dead. Yeah, everybody, like, is dead or not working.
Nonsense! You're just getting started, laddie.
Enemy targets on sensor.
Stop trying to attack me.
Enemy target on sensors. Personal shield losing power.
I've had more than enough of this.
Terran forces, this is the Admiral. We're leaving. Now!
Good luck with your fool's errand, Noi. You'll need it.
Well, that battle could have gone a lot better. That was pretty terrible battle right there.
Lita's shot sent a power surge through the command relays. They're offline, but Scotty and I can get them running again. We just need the time. Losing the Terran fleet won't make Noi happy. He'll send every ship he has at the Enterprise. You need to keep her safe while we finish the job here.
All right, let's go do this on the outside. Admiral, the Terran fleet has withdrawn. Remaining enemy forces are regrouping. It looks like they're focusing on the Enterprise. Alliance forces, this is Admiral Rami Summers. Protect the Enterprise at all
costs. And I need more time. Protect the Enterprise.
They're coming in from 3 o'clock.
Engaging hostiles, Command. Weapons hot.
Incoming. Four shields failing. All integrity below 75%.
12 o'clock!
Command, the USS Tempest is at your disposal.
The USS Poe stands ready, Command.
We got you back!
Target shields have failed. Four shields failing.
Mayday! Mayday! Our core's about to breach!
Enemy forces headed for our position. Hold them off!
Well, that happened. That happened. Those ships, man, they hit really hard. Where'd the Enterprise go? Oh, over there.
They're coming in from 9 o'clock!
A pretty intense battle. Come on, guys, why aren't you helping allies? What's this dude doing? Why ain't he working?
Structural integrity compromised. Repeat.
Hold out for just a moment longer. Sensors indicate a large ship headed your way.
Wow. Wow. I mean, what a battle. I feel really inadequate for this battle. I mean, it's tough. This is really tough.
Mayday! Mayday! Our core's about to breach!
As ready as we'll ever be. Just give the welcome.
Fire. Fire, fire, fire.
It's working. The Toxutan is disrupting the expanse. There go the spear builders too. And good riddance.
Good, because they were doing a lot of damage to my hull. And I was not happy about that.
This isn't over. I have all the time I need to find the path to victory.
He's going to run. He's done it many times before. Disable the anorex if you can, and take Noi alive. He should answer for his crimes.
All this loot, but I really can't take any of it because my inventory is so full. So now we got to take Noi out. Am I going to get any help in that, or are you guys going to stay back there?
Warning, ship is under attack.
Thanks for the save. Following your lead.
Why won't the Enterprise come? We need her.
That was close. Thanks. We'll be right behind you.
We're still in the fight, thanks to you.
Alright, we got some backup. I want to see the Enterprise fight, though. I really wish the Enterprise would join this fight with us here. I think we got him. I have a tactical beam in sight aboard Anorax. Beam us down. It's time to end this. I'm gonna take him on face to face. We're reading a fluctuating level of chronoton energy within Anorax. Their temporal drive may have taken damage in the fight and become unstable. You are close to the bridge. I suggest securing it and shutting down the temporal core before it reaches critical levels. Okay, those things do a lot of damage. This last mission, man, they ramped it up on the difficulty scale, or at least in terms of damage enemies do and so forth. I mean, they kind of ramped it up.
Warning,
might also be down to these new temporal powers that they're using, like temporal bridge officer powers, maybe. Access denied. Well, that didn't work.
Sorry I couldn't greet you properly on the bridge. I'm afraid I had more pressing matters to tend to elsewhere. Rest assured, I'll be dealing with you and your thugs soon enough.
This won't end well for you. Threaten him a little. Scan, ship Noi. Noi is in temporal engineering. It looks like he's trying to open a time vortex without fixing the temporal core. If he does so, the core will breach. The subsequent shockwave will devastate most of the Beta Quadrant. He's lost it. Let's get down there. He lost it a long time ago, man. A long time ago. All this loot I really, really want to take so I can sell for energy credits, but I just don't have the space. No space. Whatever that was, wow. That was a thing. I died twice. Yeah, these I think are the new temporal bridge officer powers, which I haven't used at all yet. And chronoton mines, but man, let me tell you, those temporal powers are crazy.
I suppose this was inevitable. So be it. It's time. Time I put an end to the charade. And to you!
Defeat Noi. He's probably pretty tough. And he's got some temporal tricks up his sleeve.
Thank you.
Eh, I'm stuck. I can't move. Oh, there we go.
And so it ends. Finish your bloody work, then. Send me to join Clauda in Oblivion, as you've sent the Deuterians and so many others. Kill me if you had the stomach for it.
It's not your turn, Noi. You'll live and face judgment for your crimes.
This won't end with me. Others are out there watching. They see your tyranny and they'll rise up just as I did. Your time will come. Pity I won't be there to see it.
Noi has been taken into custody. Beam him to the brig. Shut down the temporal core. Accolade complete. Future proof. Noi is secure in the bridge. We're ready to beam you back. We did it. And Daniels is
back.
Sorry,
I'm late.
Daniels, aren't you...
dead? I was, in a manner of speaking. Stopping Noi altered the timeline in a number of ways, including one where I lived.
Yay?
Noi is done, but his allies are still out there. Any of them could try to take Procyon again, so we'll need to stay vigilant. And so, for now, this is goodbye.
Good to see you again, my friend.
Well, Scotty, let's get you back to the 24th century.
Do you mind a quick stop in the 23rd first? I'd like to see the Enterprise, our Enterprise, one last time.
I think that can be arranged, old friend.
That's cool.
Two to beam up.
They're using the old transporter effect. Interesting. Oh, that's cool. And I look off into the distance.
It's good to know they're out there. People who come through in the end. People like you. What you did today will remain secret. No parades, no celebrations. Still, there's comfort in knowing the timeline's secure. Take pride in that. On behalf of myself and the countless others you've saved today, thank you.
Now, go hire people from your own century instead of people from the past to do your bidding. Notice that the time agents tend to do that. They like to hire people from the past to do the work for them instead of, you know, doing the work themselves. Just saying.
Well done. With your help, we were able to stop Noi and preserve the timeline. I am proud to have worked with you, my friend. Dosi Danya.
Okay, we're going to take this. This is going to allow me to train one bridge officer in the use of a new specialization, be a temporal operative. However, I don't have a ship that has temporal seating on it, so I won't be able to use those powers, but maybe one day I will, who knows. And then, of course, we've got basically disruptor weapons, or phaser, or plasma. None of that benefits me at all. So the only thing that really helps here would possibly be the Trillium D plating, which is a kinetic and all energy damage resistance and increases starship maximum hit points and maximum shield capacity and adds 7.5% of your aux power to your shield power. And you're immune to the effects of the Delphic Expanse. So if you want to build a real good tank, this could go right up there with the neutronium. I keep forgetting what it's called. Yes, neutronium. So right up there with the fleet version of the neutronium, for example, which also can increase your ship hit points. You can have two things that do that, plus shield. So all those two together can really make a nice tank on a cruiser. Probably really good during the Procyon STF stuff, I'm guessing, because that's probably what it's built for. The Procyon 5 STF. If you use that in there, it probably help you a lot more. Well, we'll take it. Accolade complete, Ragnarok. Now my thing is just completely full. And did it even put it in there? I want to make sure. Yeah, okay, I got my two things. I'm just going to have to go empty my inventory and deal with that. Wow, so that is it, my friends. We have finished the complete storyline of Star Trek Online from 2000. It took from 2015 to 2016. It took me a year to do, a lot longer than I had planned or wanted it to take. And in that time, We had some season updates. We had a whole expansion. A lot of things changed over time, but that's how things go. That's how it goes. Now, if you do or do not know, I have an original playthrough of the Federation faction in Star Trek Online that I did a long time ago. I want to say it was around 2012, but I could be wrong on that date or that year, but I know it was very early in Star Trek Online. It might even be earlier, maybe 2011 or 10. I don't know. Maybe not that early. I do know this. I've been playing the game since, you know, the game was launched. In fact, I've been playing the game since it was in beta. And it was maybe a year after I've been playing the game that I started the YouTube channel and then did my first playthrough in this. So I have a very old playthrough of the Federation side. I did a character named Ensign Ricky. And I'll put a link up in top so you can go check that out, top right corner. You can click that and you can go check out that playlist and that old run through, and you can maybe see some differences between the game then and the game now. I think it was before free to play. I think it was before the free to play edition of the game. I want to say it was. Maybe it wasn't. I don't remember. Gosh, it's been so long. I can't remember if it was pre free to play or post free to play. But I know it was on the paying version of the game anyway, because I have a lifetime account, so I played it on that. I just don't know if it was before free-to-play was launched or if it was after that. I can't remember. But anyway, I'll put a link. Once I go check it out, I'll be reminded. But you guys can check that old playthrough out. It's really cool because you could compare the game then to the game now and kind of see the differences between the two. So that might be fun. Anyway, besides that, here we are, 100th video. We finished all the missions. A whole lot of missions have been added since the original playthrough that I did. Now I've done this whole playthrough on the free-to-play edition. I have that experience between playing on a paid version of Star Trek, the lifetime account, with all the veteran rewards. And now I have the experience of playing this game free-to-play, no perks at all. So what I'm going to do from here on out is I'm going to take a little break on Rami Summers for right now. There's going to be a little break, so there's going to be a lot of time between now and the next video for Rami Summers, but I am going to continue making videos on Rami Summers. I just want to get some better upgrades before I continue those videos, because what I want to do is I want to show you guys all the STFs on this character. Since it's free to play and it's in game, I can show you how you can upgrade with all that and then have the do well in those STFs. I want to play all the ground STFs, space STFs, at least, you know, all the Borg ones, all the main ones that people play, all the newest ones, stuff like that. So that's going to be that could be pretty lengthy if I play all of them. So there's a whole lot of potential there for a new video doing the STFs. Plus, it'll kind of show you how to play the STFs if you don't know. But that's going to come a little later. Like I said, I need a little bit of a break on her right now because I'm going to start another series. Also, I want to get more upgrades. So I'm working through the Iconian Resistance reputation. As you can see, I'm only halfway up on Tier 5. I want to open up all of Tier 5 so I can get all four pieces of the Iconian set, like I mentioned, on my starship. Right? Then I want to upgrade my weapons because they're really kind of not that great. I want to upgrade the actual weapons on my ship, better modifiers, better quality, that sort of thing. And then just upgrade. I want to upgrade everything to Mark 14, especially my tactical consoles. You know, I want to get the most Tetrion damage I can get out of this thing. So there's a lot of things here I want to upgrade and do before I do more on this character, before I really go in and do all the STFs. And so all that's just going to take time. Every day I'll log in and get some more marks and do the reputation and, you know, give it some time, and I will get all that stuff upgraded, and then I will make some more videos on Rami Summers. So this is not the last you will see of Rami Summers at all. And it also not the last of Ensign Ricky as well. I have done some stuff previously on him. After not using him for a while, I did use him again for a little bit. So these characters will pop up every now and then in the future as I do more videos as needed on these characters. So don't worry about that. There will be more content to follow on this character here. People are asking me, am I going to do a free-to-play run-through now of the KDF and the Romulans, considering I have already done those? So yeah, if you don't know, I've already done Romulan and KDF on the paying version of the game. So I also have run-throughs of those. Don't miss that. If I can fit all this in there in the cards in the top right when you click that, I will put all the links to these playlists in there so you can check them out, because I do have a Romulan playthrough of the game, and I do have a KDF playthrough of the game. In fact, I think I got two KDF playthroughs, or at least one. I know at least I got one Romulan, maybe two KDF, because I did an updated one at some point. Maybe I didn't. I don't remember. I don't know. Anyway, I know I got stuff there. So you can check those out. But am I going to do one of the free-to-play version? Well, at this time, I don't have it planned to do that, simply because I've already done those, and I don't think there would be any difference on the free-to-play side. Now that I've done the Federation side, I know what the game is like with free-to-play, so I don't know if I would learn anything particularly new between those two factions that I haven't learned on the Federation faction playing free-to-play. That said, maybe in the future I will, because the game is ever evolving and ever changing. New seasons come out, new expansions come out, the game changes, and you know, I'm sure people will want to see what the game is like as it continues to be updated. So for 2016 at least, probably no Romulan or KDF run through on free to play. But for 2017 or 2018, maybe I will. Maybe when 2017 rolls around, you know, I'll do another playthrough. I mean, it's very possible. But I have no guarantees on that, so I don't know. But obviously, the only way to find out if I do a playthrough is to subscribe, and you know, then you'll be updated if I do new videos. Now, what I am going to do, like I just said, is continue videos with this character. And I am going to make a video now that I'm done with all of this, comparing the free-to-play versus the paying version, lifetime version or whatever. I'm going to go on the website and see what the differences are between free-to-play and a paying version of the game, and I'll put that in a video and you can see straight up what the differences are. But then I'll also talk about my experiences, what I felt was constraining or held me back on free-to-play versus the paying version or having veteran perks. So I'm going to talk about those things in a separate video and just totally go over my experience playing the game on free-to-play versus paying, and this will maybe give you guys some insight if you might want to subscribe to the game or get a lifetime account or something like that. So I'll just give my opinions. It'll be one video, and it won't be very fancy. It'll just be me standing here telling you my opinions of the game and how it differs between both. Pretty much that simple. So look forward to that coming. I don't know when that will be published, but when it is, I'll have it. And then the other thing is that now that I am done with Rami Summers on this series playthrough, I can start another one. So I am now going to do the new Star Trek Online Agents of Yesterday expansion. It is still time for me to make it a temporal recruit. The time is not expired yet as of this recording. So I will make an Agents of Yesterday temporal recruit 23rd century Starfleet character and do a playthrough of that all the way through. So I won't record every single video because I'm not going to record missions that I've already played, like the standard missions, you know, like Stranded in Space and stuff like that. But I will play all of the new 23rd century missions, all of the new Agents of Yesterday missions, all of the new future-proof missions or whatever is related to that series itself. So that's what's next. A brand new series. Again, if you subscribe, you can you know, see the get the updates on those videos coming out, because well, that's going to start up next, and I want to get through it pretty quickly. Well, I got to get at least to a certain point on the temporal recruit so that I am a temporal recruit before the time runs out. I definitely want it to be a temporal recruit character. I'm going to do that, and I'm also going to create a character on my free-to-play version of the game here as well in the 23rd century, so that Rami Summers can benefit from all the temporal, I don't know what you call them, rewards that you get through in the game. But by having a temporal recruit, you can get these temporal rewards. And I want Rami Summers to have those temporal rewards as well. So I'm going to make a temporal recruit Agents of Yesterday character on my free-to-play version as well, so that she can enjoy those benefits. So anyway, that's what's to come. Lots here left. I mean, this is not the end by any means. It's the end of, not even the end of this series, because I do plan to do more with her as I get her up there. Just going to take time. That's why I need a bit of a break right now, because I need to, you know, take that time to do those upgrades and everything on her and get her to where I want her. So that just takes time. You just got to play the game, grind out the game, and do what's necessary. Once I get there, then I'll make new videos about it. And that's pretty much it. I have enjoyed playing on the free-to-play. I haven't spent a dime, not a single dime. I think that it wouldn't have been as enjoyable if I didn't get this free Vorgon ship during the summer event. If I hadn't got this Vorgon ship, I don't think it would have been as good with the in-game ship you end up with, which is a tier 5 ship. So that was a plus. But otherwise, I have had a lot of fun on the free-to-play. I mean, just as much fun playing on free-to-play as I had on a paying version. My fun factor is pretty much the same, so that tells you something right there. Very enjoyable. I mean, just imagine, this game's pretty in-depth, pretty long. The story missions, even though there's a lot of plot holes, it's pretty long and pretty in-depth for a free game that you don't have to spend a dime on. Just imagine that this exists. In this world today, you can play a game that's completely free and has this level of immersion. That's incredible, guys. Incredible. And it's a Star Trek game. So, kudos. Kudos for that being a thing, for that being a reality. This didn't used to be a reality. I mean, I've grown up with computers all my life. And, you know, back in the early days, there was no free games. There were no free MMOs. There was no free Star Trek game. There have been several good Star Trek games, but not a whole lot. So, you know, the fact that this exists, I'm like, wow, I'm happy about that. The kind of experience I can have. And you can team up with other people and share that experience. So it's a lot of fun. Anyway, I'm kind of rambling and going off the rails now, but I'm going to say a lot more about all that in the my kind of final review video between this to explain the free-to-play version. Anyway, I'm rambling. Thank you all for watching this series. I just want to thank everybody who has stayed with it and watched every one of these videos. Or if you're new and you're just coming in and you're going to watch this series, thank you so much for that. I mean, without your support, without your viewership, without y'all actually watching these videos, there would be no point in me to do this. I do this for you guys, too, so you can see what this game is all about. And I enjoy that. So I do it for you. And yeah, I really appreciate that. I mean, I couldn't do this if nobody watched it. There would be no point. So yeah, I really, really, really appreciate it. And I hope you guys stick around for more, because like I said, there's going to be more. So thank you all for watching. This has been a lot of fun, and I'll see you guys out there.